If you have already subscribed, then click the bell icon to get instant notifications when I put a new video up. Do it now. What's up guys, I am Rob and welcome back to my channel, Math Stuff with Rob. I don't know why I said that. Okay, so today I'm going to do a DIY project that I personally like. Tell me this guys, how do people react when you say bugs? Ew! No, just keep it away, keep it, don't come close to me, just keep it away. Please, please, no! That's right, but the bugs I am going to make today will make people go, ooh, wow, that looks awesome. Oh my God, can I touch it? Can I touch it? Please, please, can I touch it? Once. Can I touch it? Can I take it? That's right, that's how we roll on this channel. So get ready, it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. All right, let's begin. You saw what I did there? Begin. Okay, I'll get to the DIY. So I am making bugs. So when you're making bugs, you need to decide what kind of a bug you want to make. So I have done a sketch over here. You can look at references from the net or pick up magazines or just step outdoors, look at some, draw them out and then make them. So you can see I have made a rough sketch of a bug, and following this sketch, I am going to make paper beetle, which will have a 3D look. So it's almost like a 3D beetle. So for that, I'm gonna keep this aside. This is my reference. Now I'm going to take another sheet of paper, and on this, I am going to make my beetle. Now what I'm going to do is, like I said, I'm going to make a 3D one. So I'm going to divide the body and the head. So on this sheet of paper, I'm going to draw the body. First, I'll fold it in half because you can see the shape of the beetle is pretty symmetrical. There you go. Now let's draw on this. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to draw only half of the body. So you can see that there are two halves, both look pretty symmetrical. So just following the curve, I'm going to draw this simple shape. So you can see it's this part. Now obviously I'm drawing it slightly bigger. The reason is when you're scoring it to make it look 3D, the form becomes slightly smaller. And that's why I'm making it bigger here. So after scoring, it'll come to roughly this size. So you have to keep that in mind. Okay, so the body is done. Now we'll do the same thing for the head. Another sheet of paper. Let's fold this in half. And I'll draw half of the head again. Now I'm going to cut this out cleanly. So there you go. You can see we have the body and the head. And like I said, the shape is slightly bigger than the actual sketch over here. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to explain the whole technique on this white chart paper. So first we'll make a small cut at the bottom. When you open it, you'll see you have a cut on either side. Look at that. Now you can just stick this like this, overlapping, just like that. And you automatically get a nice curved shape and it starts looking slightly 3D-ish. But I want the sides also to be slightly raised. So to explain it better, I'm going to make a line here. Now to score, take a cutter and apply a little bit of pressure. So you're creating a dent. So you're cutting it slightly, but don't apply too much pressure. Otherwise, you will cut through the paper and you don't want that. So we'll do it on the other side as well, like that. So it's a little raised on the side. And you can just bend it a little bit. Now we'll just stick this. To stick it, I'm using white glue. So with this cut and this scoring line, the body is done. So we'll keep it aside. Now I'll show you what to do on the head portion. So we'll do a similar technique. Around this curve line, I'll make a line where we will score. With scoring, it becomes easier to actually create folds or bends in portions which are curved like this. So here you can see we have a nice 3D form happening. Once you're happy with it, then you can use this as your template and you can get your pages from the magazine or colored chart paper, whatever you want to use. I am using pages from the magazines, so I'm going to get that in. So you can see I have some pages from the magazines and I've taken out pieces that I like where there's nice color or there is some kind of a pattern. Okay, so I'm going to use this one for the body. Maybe I can also try a red one and let's see which one looks better. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to trace this, use this as a template and trace this. There you go. You can see that it looks really nice, the whole pattern on this. Now we'll stick this little slit that we had made. So we'll overlap it like this and stick it in place using some white glue. Okay, so the body is done. Now following the same technique, I'll make the head. Okay, so the head is also done. I'm pretty happy with it. So now I'll show you how to make the legs. So we'll move this aside, bring in one black sheet again. So just go back to the reference, maybe look at one of the legs and follow that. And I'm gonna score a line on the inside and create the same 3D effect like that, and then you can just cut it in half so you have legs for either side like that. And for the thinner portion that I have here, I'm going to use this wire. Now you can paint the wire black using a marker or acrylic colors, or if you want to add a little bit of thickness, you can use floral tape and just go around it like that. Just keep rolling it tightly like that. With tape, you can cover the whole wire. So you can see it also adds a bit of volume, so it looks slightly thicker and it has a nice clean coat on it. So you can either paint it or you can put some tape like this. And here I have coated the whole wire with tape. So I'm going to use a piece of that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to stick this wire on the inside of the leg like this. So this way you get the thinner portion of the leg. And also when you're placing the bug onto a surface, you can just bend the wire, fold it in different directions to give it a little bit of height. So let's place and see how it looks. And then if it looks nice, following the same technique, you can make the rest of the legs. I think this looks pretty cool, looks pretty realistic. So let's make the rest of the legs. Okay, so you can see we have all the pieces here. Now we will stick them and then we can mount it in a frame. To maintain the 3D shape, I'm going to use some pieces of cardboard to give it some height. So let's start with the head. As you can see, I'm placing a piece of cardboard. And on this piece, I'll attach the legs. Okay, looks like we are done. As you can see, I have placed the head and the body, attached the legs. Look at that, looks pretty realistic. And because of the magazine paper, it has a nice glossy finish and really nice pattern and color gradation happening here. So this looks pretty realistic. I'm very happy with this. And like I said, using this technique, you can try different color variations and make them look cool. So now let's frame this and see how it looks. I I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video and found this tutorial helpful. So now you can make some bugs and I don't know, bug someone or make some and hang them up in your room as room decor. And don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. If you have, you are amazing. Now look around, if anyone hasn't subscribed, then bug them till they do. Also, in the comment section below, you can suggest more DIY projects that I should try. Okay, what else? I think that's it, guys. Thank you for stopping by and watching this video. I'll see you in my next one. Till then, do good and be good. Peace.